Ascension Day, right. Right. Thursday was Ascension Day. If you lived in Dwayne's house when he was growing up, that was a day of rest. I was going to say a holiday, but a holiday as in the sense it was like almost like a Sabbath. It was a day of rest. It was a day that was remembered and was acknowledged and was celebrated. And so we're celebrating Ascension Day today because this is the day that we're together. So we're going to be talking a little bit later, a little bit about Jesus' ascension and a little bit about heaven too. So I always get excited when we talk about heaven. Anything you'd like to share, though? Anything that's been happening in the last while or somewhere where you've seen God active around you? Okay. You guys ready? Jesus said, and I'm reading from John 14, 1-3, and then we're going to move on to Acts chapter 1. Jesus said, "Don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. I wouldn't tell you this if it weren't true. I'm going there to prepare a place for you. And I go and prepare a place for you. I will come back and take you to be with me so that you may be where I am." Leave a space. So where is Jesus? If I would ask you this morning, where's Jesus? What would you say? Where's Jesus? Would you say in heaven? That's what the story of Jesus' ascension tells us. But what if I asked you, where is heaven? What would you say?
Up.
Up?
There.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Heaven is up? Up where?
Up in the sky.
Up in the sky. Heaven is the place where Jesus is and where God is, right? Living somewhere way up in the sky? Living somewhere way up in our universe? In Genesis chapter 1, it says that God created the heavens and the earth. Now, when I read that verse, I take that to mean the earth. The earth is where we live. It's where the animals live. It's where the plants grow. And then we have the overarching sky up above us, where the birds fly and where the clouds form. That is heaven, or the heavens, as it says, the earth and the heavens. But is a heaven somewhere up there, somewhere up there beyond the clouds? That's what I thought when I was young. I'd lie in the grass and I'd gaze up into the sky. And I'd wonder where heaven was, how far up heaven was. Is it way up beyond the stars? But now we have the Hubble telescope, and we know the universe is much bigger than what we did when I was your guy's age. The universe, they're found, it goes on and on and on. And astronauts have went to the moon. And they haven't seen heaven, and they haven't seen God. So is heaven somewhere up there in the sky? Really, really, really far away? And is God in this heaven somewhere really, really, really far away, with Jesus sitting at his right hand? Farther away than the Hubble telescope can even see? And it reminded me of a song, "God is watching us from a distance." I love to imagine what it would have been like when Jesus was here on earth. Would have loved to have been here when Jesus was here on earth. To see him, to listen to him talk, to see the miracles, to see a lame man, couldn't walk for many, many years, come back onto his feet and be healed again. We've come through the period of Lent and Jesus' death and his resurrection. And in Acts 1, we have a count of what Jesus did after he rose from the dead. It says in that scripture that you heard that Jesus proved over and over again that he was who he said he was, that it really was him. He had to prove it sounds like, over and over again. It says that he taught them about the kingdom of God. And he told them about the Holy Spirit, this gift that God was going to send. And then we're told that one day they were talking together, and it says that Jesus was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. That's pretty amazing. It would have been so neat to be there. And I've always pictured Jesus rising up into the sky and going higher and higher. And kind of, have you ever watched when a space shuttle goes up and you see it going further and further and further until finally he disappears in the clouds? And it could have been that way. We weren't there, so we don't know what it was like. But in the Old Testament, a cloud signifies God's presence. If you remember, God led the children of Israel in the desert with a pillar of cloud and fire. Cloud and smoke filled the temple when God's presence was there in a new way. And there are other times as well that it talks about a cloud that signifies the presence of God. So Jesus being taken up into a cloud, I would suggest, signifies Jesus going back to be with God, back to God's space, God's dimension, where God is, where God is. And it says that he will be back one day when that dimension, that space, and our space are brought together once and for all. See, when the Bible talks about heaven and about heaven and earth, they're talking about kind of like two halves of God's created world. Heaven is God's space, and earth is our space. Heaven is where God dwells. Earth is where we live. It's not necessarily somewhere way, way far away in the sweet by and by. That somewhere, if you look high enough, you'll see it somewhere way, way up in space. Heaven is God's space. It's where God lives, where God is. And it intersects with our space. They're very close. It's right here. Heaven is right here all around us. And there's places where the curtain between heaven and earth is a little thinner, almost transparent. If you remember the story of Stephen, when Stephen was being stoned, it said Stephen looked up and he saw Jesus sitting or standing, Jesus standing at the right side of God in heaven. It's because heaven is right there and he saw it. When you think of when Jesus encountered Saul, who became Paul, as he was traveling to Damascus, all of a sudden a voice speaks to him right there. It says he saw a light. Have you ever experienced a time when you were aware of God's presence with you in a very special way, in a way that was a little more closer than normal? And it may have been seeing a beautiful rainbow or being on a holiday and seeing the beauty of creation. Music. Music affects me tremendously. And there are times I'm in tears when I hear a song. It just impacts me. Newborn child, having that newborn baby laid in your arms. Heaven is closer than we think. And Jesus is closer than we think. Jesus ascended to be with his Father, to be with God. And it's not somewhere way, way far away, but it's very close to us. Jesus' ascension tells us a number of different things. It tells us where Jesus is. It also tells us some other things as well, and we'd like to look at those. Jesus' ascension tells us, this one just really struck me this week, a human person is in heaven. A human person is now in God's space. Jesus was human. He's the first of many of us who will eventually go. But Jesus, a human person, now belongs to both God's space, heaven, and our space. He was here, and now he's there. I think that's pretty amazing. I think that's pretty incredible. We brought seeds this morning so that we could pray for our growing season. In 1 Corinthians 15, it compares our earthly bodies as seeds. Now, if you look at some of these seeds down here, some of them look kind of ugly. Some of them are kind of dry. They're brown. Some of them are green. But they're pretty dry looking. They don't look very nice. Well, 1 Corinthians, it describes our earthly bodies like seeds. But it talks about our resurrection bodies. And our resurrected bodies are the produce of those seeds. What happens when you plant a seed? It starts to grow. It starts to grow. And you get delicious fruit. And you get beautiful flowers. And you get these big fields of rippling golden grain. Looks beautiful. That's the difference between our bodies now and what our resurrected bodies will be someday. Jesus ascended to heaven as a physical body, as a physical person with a body, not as some disembodied spirit. Jesus had a body. You could touch him. He ate. But there was also a difference. He could go through doors when they were closed. He could suddenly appear and disappear. Jesus' body, Jesus' death and resurrection and ascension are a bit of a picture of what our bodies may be like someday. We don't know exactly what it'll be like, but when we look at Jesus, we see a picture of what it might be like for us someday as well. And I think it's really neat to imagine what that would be like and what it will be like someday. So Jesus' ascension tells us that a human person is now with God. Jesus' ascension also tells us that Jesus has been exalted to heaven, into God's space. It says that he's seated at the right hand of God in different places in Scripture. That means that he is seated in a place of supreme privilege and divine authority. Jesus is the rightful Lord of heaven and of earth. He's the King of kings, and he's the Lord of lords. He's not an absent landowner. The picture of, when I got thinking about this week, this picture of Jesus being somewhere way far away, it's kind of like an absent landowner, not really close, but hearing from a distance. He's not somewhere far, far away, but he's here with us, present with us, sharing our joys and our sorrows, joining with us as we long for the day when all of creation, when heaven and earth are together again and will perfectly reflect the way God meant it to be and planned it to be from the very beginning, a place where God's love and where his justice and his peace flow. I imagine that when Jesus' followers looked up and saw him leave, that they felt abandoned. Here they were just getting used to having him back again after he died. And he told them he'll never leave them. And now he does. And next week we're going to celebrate Pentecost. And at Pentecost, as the Holy Spirit fell on them, they recognized in a brand new way that Jesus hadn't left them, not at all, but that he was actually more present with them than when he was literally here. He was more real than ever, not restricted to certain locations, but with them wherever they went, whatever they were doing. That is something that I think is so precious, because the Holy Spirit has come upon us and is in us, then the presence of Jesus is with us. If Jesus was here with us this morning, physically here, then he couldn't be at the Free Methodist Church, because he's here. But because he went away, the Holy Spirit is with us, and through the Holy Spirit, Jesus is right here with us. And he's doing his work through us and empowering us to be his witnesses here in the world. If Jesus' ascension tells us that Jesus is seated at the right hand of God in heaven, it also tells us then that as his followers, we are also seated with him in heaven. And if you look at Colossians 3, Paul makes a phenomenal statement in Colossians 3, starting at verse 1. It says, "Since we've been raised with Christ, we are to set our hearts and minds on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God, not on earthly things, for we've died and our life is now hidden with Christ in God." Our life is hidden with Christ in God. As followers of Jesus, we are to live as if we are with Jesus in heaven, in that invisible spiritual realm, because in a very real sense, we already do. We don't belong to this world any longer. We live here on earth. This is where we carry out the mission that Jesus has given us. We live here filled with the Holy Spirit. Jesus is Lord of our life, and our attitudes, our ambitions, our thoughts, our actions, our relationships, our whole outlife look on life is shaped by our relationship with Jesus Christ. And it's all because of what God's done for us in Jesus' life and in his death, his resurrection, his ascension, and his exaltation. Jesus is King and Lord over all creation, and we are living in a very real sense with him. So Jesus' ascension tells us that a human person is now in God's space. It tells us that Jesus is exalted to the right hand of God, and since that's true, then we are also hidden with Christ in God. We are in a very real sense with him. Jesus' ascension also tells us that Jesus will return again. The angels said to the disciples, Jesus has been taken away from you into heaven, and someday, just as you saw him go, he'll return. Jesus will come back again. It's a promise, and a promise that all followers of Jesus, all Christians, have been hanging on to for a long time now, but we continue to believe and to trust God's promise that Jesus will come back again. To say that Jesus ascended to heaven is to say that he's going to come back again, but he's going to come back again one day, bringing heaven and earth together as one. Heaven, God's space, will be our home for a time if we die before Jesus returns. Then it says that we go to be in the presence of the Lord. So this heaven, this God's place, will be our home for a time if we die before Christ returns. But when Jesus returns, we're told that he will bring heaven and earth together once and for all. And you go to Revelation 21 and you have this wonderful picture, wonderful, beautiful scene of new heaven and new earth coming down out of heaven from God. And the unseen will become visible as God transforms the whole of the universe. And our future everlasting home is a joined, transformed, new heaven and new earth, more glorious than anything we can possibly imagine. What we do here right now makes a difference, because we are going to be living in a transformed world, joined together, but what we do here makes a difference. Again, in Colossians 3, Paul says that when Christ, who is your real life, is revealed to the world, you will share in all his glory. When Christ, who is your real life, is revealed to the whole world, you will share in all his glory. One day, God's plans are going to be completely unfolded, and Jesus will be revealed to the world for who he is. And it says there that we too will be revealed for who we already are. And I love the verses that John writes in 1 John 3:2. He says, "Dear friends, now we are the children of God. And what we will be has not yet been made known, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is." We can speculate, we don't know exactly what it'll be like, but we know that we will be like him when he appears, for we shall see him as he is. Whenever I see a yellow finch, I'm reminded of a few years ago when we had one living around our house. And it would kept landing on our small stairway window. And it would look in, and then it would fly up and down the glass as if it was trying to get in. Had this whole big world out there where this little finch could fly around and where it could enjoy its life. And yet, it seemed to me it was like it saw something in our house or saw something that it really yearned for, that it wanted to get into the house. That little finch spoke to me. And I hope that little finch is like us. We can enjoy life. We can enjoy all that life has to offer. We can enjoy living our lives for Jesus. And yet, like that little finch, there's something missing. Something we yearn for. Something we squint to see a little bit more clearly. We yearn to be with our wonderful Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ forever. Be encouraged this morning. God keeps his promises. Jesus' ascension tells us that he has gone back to be with his Father and that he will come again when we will all be with him forever. 1 Corinthians 4:16 says, "For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God. The dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up with them in the air, in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage each other with these words."